Okay, so we have the shot set. Welcome to Tech Tuesday. Hey, Chucky.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Okay, try not to laugh. I know. It's like I'm walking around with Mickey Mouse ears on right? No, this is good, though.
But you're off center.
I am off center?
Yeah.
Okay, hang on a second. Well, you want to fix me? Okay, good. Okay, now welcome to the vlog, everybody.
Yeah, there we go.
All right, we're actually going to have this discussion again, and I stick up for you guys, the owners of the car, because I fully understand. And it's funny because I gave these to Chuck. We're going to install these jacking pucks on my C8 today. And I did get these from my buddies at ACS Composite. Chuck goes, well, you didn't get them from Paragon? Well, they didn't have any blue ones.
Well, you know.
So I had to have blue. But they actually have two bolts on here.
Yes.
That you like. So the conversation, where's your other puck at that we were going to talk about?
Over on the rack.
Okay, so here's the conversation that Chuck and I had a long time ago with C8 regarding jacking pucks.
So, as you can see...
Well, yeah, because from our first video we talked about this, you said you didn't care for these.
Correct.
You preferred something thicker, and
correct,
here's the reason why.
Here's the reason why.
Because these are the things you use on the rack when,
yes,
you're servicing the vehicle.
Right, and you can see this step up, and the problem is...
Here, you kind of need to... Right, go ahead.
Well, I'm in center. I can see you can't.
Okay.
The problem, the step up on these rack pads is,
right,
the problem. As you can see, this one sticks way up above.
So when there's not a jacking puck in there from the clients like this, you,
right,
put that in the hole.
Yeah, I put this in the hole. That,
okay,
way it gives me this much space between the car and the jacking pad.
Okay, so when you put this on, it really doesn't give you much at all.
No.
And that's when you're putting sometimes wood in there.
Yeah, I have to put wood in between like this.
Okay.
That's why I have my wood here.
Right.
This is broke, but this way it gets this up away from the car.
Okay. So you're trying not to scratch the underside of the car.
Correct.
But you know what, though? I'll tell you what, though. Man, if you look here, I mean, it's still above this piece, but I get what you're saying. And here's the reason why I think this works for me and for a lot of you. Because when you've got to get down here like this, look underneath. I still can't find where the jacking points are. So those pucks are going to be quite helpful. Because now when I'm changing out my tires for my autocross, yeah, as you saw, looking underneath there, and my eyes are bad.
Oh, yeah, it's dark under there.
You're used to this, man. You could do this with your eyes closed where these plug in. I don't know where they're jacking, but I can't even find where to put the darn thing in if I had one of those. So these are going to be beautiful.
Yeah.
And they go with my car.
Well, of course they do.
Okay.
Or you wouldn't have bought them.
Absolutely. We also going to have some Tech Tuesday emails from you guys here in just a moment. But first, we're going to let Chuck put these on. We're also going to talk about what we did a couple of weeks ago. Did you get the dielectric grease?
I haven't.
You got some? Okay. And this would be a good time to do that, going into the springtime or at least once a year, talking about conditioning all the rubber seals on your C8 Corvette. We're going to do that with you guys here in the vlog in just a moment. Thanks for joining us today.
Slot, and you're going to give it a half a turn to lock it to frame,
okay,
tighten the bolts down.
Okay. And that way it'll permanently stay in there.
Correct.
It's not going to hang down too low, so you don't have to worry about when you go over some of those speed bumps and stuff like that to scratch the underside of the car. But it's going to be a nice identifier because I have a low profile jack at home and I do one tire at a time, and I need to find that jacking point. And I've got a puck that I can put up in there, but I just got tired of doing it. So thank you to our friends at ACS. Link in description if you're looking for Corvette accessories. Soon, they don't know it yet, but soon they're going to be a sponsor of our channel. But they do have some great products for you guys. I mean, incredible. Even the side rocker extension right there, painted in carbon flash, that came from ACS. And this front splitter is the factory Z51 splitter. They've sanded it down, painted it carbon flash. I'm sorry, the car's... Chuck's doing that. Car's dirty, but you could see the continuity from the splitter right up into the front fascia. That all matches. So thank you again to our friends at ACS Composite. Let's see if you can see.
Oh, there she is. Beautiful. That looks nice. Okay, see, I was looking over here. So it's a good thing you put it on there.
Oh my gosh. So you guys probably noticed, yes, the logo is off my door. I'm actually redesigning that exact logo, but I'm going to italicize it to follow the body lines of the car, and I use the car more for work than pleasure, even though they're one and the same, but I've got to have that on there from a marketing standpoint. So it is going back on the car. We've got Zora on there, of course. I've got a new sticker that's almost done that's going to go here. Our plate, the first one in the world, thanking Taj and really the Corvette team for bringing us mid-engine Corvette. And of course, my slogan is still across the windshield. Your boy Ricky coined that a long time ago, like in 2000, 2001. Stop dreaming and start driving. Rick Conti for Coughlin Corvette. Actually, originally designed logos, I had one on the hood and stuff like that, and I thought it'd be too much, but, and some of you already think that it's too much when I have those on there, but I really need to have those on there for a number of reasons. It helps promote our YouTube efforts. It does help promote the retail responsibilities here. Those go hand in hand. So thank you guys. I appreciate all of your support, the fun that we have with this car and we're able to share on the channel. And it's because of you guys I'm able to do this. And it's because of you guys I actually have this car. So I thank so many of you. How many emails do we have today? We've got, four emails?
I think so. I don't know.
Okay, we'll do those in a moment. Let's grab some dielectric grease. Let's get my convertible top open. This is something that when we talked about it, people said, hey, can you actually show us what you're talking about?
Whoa.
Is that good right there?
Yep.
Okay. All right. So before we start using the dielectric grease, the first thing I'm going to do, so there's a little bit of dirt in there.
Yeah, you can see the line here.
Yeah, I got some dirt in there. You guys probably can't see that on camera, but. Clean it off the dust?
No, that's what this does.
That'll clean that off?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't need to clean that off?
No.
Oh, I thought I had to clean it off first.
No.
Oh, okay.
You got to watch about what you put on this weather strip. It'll deteriorate it.
Okay, this stuff's not.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, it won't. Oh, gosh. I guess I'll share that part on the vlog where you're yelling at me. Okay, I thought I had to clean it off first. So here's what happens, and Chuck and I have talked about this a number of times, and it's always a good refresher. You can see some dust and dirt back in there, down in here. And your coupes are going to do the same thing from here and your B pillar. And you describe it best when that accumulates in there. What's going to happen to the folks?
Well, it seems like a rattle, but it's really not a rattle. It's a dry rubber, like itching, moving. And it sounds, the GM calls it itching. The glass is actually itching or moving on the rubber.
I call it, it almost sounds like a squeak to me at some
squeak,
point.
Squeak, rattle.
Right. Yeah. And, you know, regardless of that, you really still need to do this to keep these conditioned so they don't crack and deteriorate and cause leaks down the road from air leaks or water leaks. So,
correct.
All right, so do you want to use a rag to put that on or you got
no,
your little
I
rubber?
Use my finger.
Okay, and then I'll use a rag to take it off. So
yeah.
You could see here on the convertible, you've got this part right here. You've got that piece that goes all the way across there. You've got this piece that goes right here. So there's quite
all the
a
way
bit.
Across the front.
Across the front here. We're gonna do the sides right here where your window lays against.
You don't have to pre-clean the weather strips. You're just gonna put this on.
See, I thought I had to clean it. I wanted to get that dust off. Okay.
No.
Now I know some people watching, you know what they're gonna do. They're gonna clean the dust off anyways before they do this.
Be careful what cleaner you use on these weather strips.
Right, exactly.
That's why I use like using this dielectric grease. It's actually a grease, it's waterproof, and it soaks down into the rubber and helps waterproof them and helps them soften up.
Now the dielectric grease, what else do you use that for with your servicing and General Motors products?
Well, this is used for wiring and connectors.
Okay, so you like the water, water resistant properties in that.
If you look, you can see the weather strip's dry here. It starts getting a wet look here and it's wet all the way across. I'm not throwing handfuls of it down.
Right.
But you don't want to do that.
Okay.
Switch me sides.
Okay, sorry. I like being hands-free. This is awesome. And if you notice today, he's doing all the work.
Yeah. The easiest way I found to do this, instead of trying to rub it on, is just go along. Dab it.
Now, how long are you going to let that sit on there before we wipe it off?
5, 10, 15 minutes.
Okay.
You just want to let it soak in. And you see, I'm even though it's coated, I'm still massaging it in a little bit to work it into the rubber.
Okay.
Now, that whole weather strip is completely, has a wet look.
Now, there's nothing on the underside here, guys,
no,
so we don't have to worry about that.
To here.
Correct. But we do have a seal underneath here.
Here, come over to this side. You show them this?
Let me see. What, do I got a bunch of dirt in there?
Well, yeah, it'd probably show the dirt and show up on camera right there.
Oh, yeah.
See that, the dirt line right here?
Yep.
That's yep. what happens. So this is like drywall. They always say less is better, less is more. Same way with this grease. You don't have to go crazy with it. Just something to put a thin layer down that you're going to wipe most of the excess off anyway.
Was I right in the assumption that doing this once a year is probably recommended?
I would, yeah.
Okay. Or as needed if you start getting that itching, squeaking sound.
Correct.
In your top, in the movement. And I've had it
sure.
once when we did this, and it's been probably 8 months. It was in the late summer, early fall that we did it. But right now we're in springtime. A lot of folks are getting their cars out after been sitting around a little bit or doing some light driving, and we've had some windy days, so you are going to get some dust in there.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I mean, it's just inevitable. It's going to happen.
Nice longer vlog for you guys today to have these communications. And don't forget, at the end of today's vlog, after Chuck reads some of your questions in the Tech Tuesday viewer mail segment coming up here in a moment, we're going to have a beautiful ride segment. We didn't have one last week, and I've got, again, I say this, it's not over-exaggerated. I really got some good-looking cars for you guys to enjoy at the end of today's video. So thanks again for joining us.
Like I said, guys, you don't want to get carried away with it.
Right.
Just enough to moisten the weather strip.
As I lay my hand right in it over uh-huh. here. Nice way to go. What a goof. I just put my hand right in it.
Let it set for 10, 15 minutes, absorb into the rubber, and then we'll come back and wipe it all off.
Okay, so let's take a quick break. We'll be right back. Let's read some of your emails on today's Tech Tuesday on our Corvette channel. Thanks again for joining us. My job's easy. I just have to stand here and not make everybody dizzy. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Chuck with our Tech Tuesday. You guys do send a lot of questions, text, email. I really appreciate that. If you've got a question, how to fix something, how to maintain something, how to use something in your Corvette, if we can help, we'd be happy to send those emails in at the email address that's up on the screen right now. You got a couple today, so what do you got?
This one comes from John from California. He said he's been watching every one of your YouTube episodes, even prior to ordering my C8 in June, and I really enjoyed all the information you pass on, and you definitely have influenced my ultimate order decision. Many thanks.
Thank you.
I finally picked up my 2020 C8 HTC Hypersonic Gray 3LT with black red interior 3 weeks ago, and absolutely love it. Having said that, while on my first trip with the car, less than 300 miles on the odometer, returning my son to Florida from South Carolina, the rear view window exploded.
Whoa, wait a minute. The back window of the HTC exploded?
That's what he said.
Okay, and you looked this up. There's no bulletins on this.
No bulletins, nothing.
Whoa, okay, so what happened?
Well, he said, I thought we had been shot, but there were no cars around us, no other damage anywhere on the car. I've not been able to figure out what happened, and Chevy does not think I have a claim since other similar incidents have not been reported.
Ah.
Yeah, I haven't seen anything on it or heard anything about
it. Wow. Did he actually get it? Did you say if he got it taken care of?
After a significant number of phone calls, I was able to get a replacement glass panel, but now I have the issue is getting it installed.
Also, the Chevy dealership didn't put it in?
Evidently not.
Oh.
Obviously, I know that you and Chuck were well connected in the Corvette community. I'm wondering if you've heard of a similar breakage. And if there is a simple schematic somewhere where I could try replacing it myself. I'm far from a mechanic, but I really feel that I am out of options.
Wow.
Yeah.
You didn't get a chance to look at the schematic back there. So, folks.
I looked at it. And
yeah, you've got to go way back into here and probably have to take out the center tunnel and all that just to get to that glass area, I'm assuming, yes? Or do you got to come from the backside?
Too.
Yeah, it's another convertible. Wow.
I mean, there's a lot you have to take off of it before you can even attempt the glass.
Right.
And then once you get the glass out.
You're probably going to take stuff out from the inside and from the backside, actually, yes. When you look back here.
Yeah.
Oh,
and
wow.
Then you got to put a bead of urethane down and get it centered back in there. I mean, you're almost going to have to find a professional glass someplace that'll put it in for him. I wouldn't attempt it.
Hey, all right, what else you got here?
All right, this one comes from Stefan.
Well, anyways, let's go back to the guy with the back window.
Yeah.
I say let a Chevy dealership do it. Maybe get a body shop involved with it when you got to disassemble that much. Is that probably a good suggestion?
Probably, but I mean, even here, we don't install our own glass. We have a glass company come in and do it for us.
Right.
So yeah, you need to, I'm sure a dealer, local dealer somewhere would have a similar case where they have people sure. come in and work with their glass.
Okay, that's not a bad idea. Call your local dealership, see if they have a glass company that puts in windshields and things like that. He might have...
Even a body shop, like you said.
Yeah, either one.
When you wreck a car, something happens, the first thing that breaks is glass, so...
Okay. All right. Okay. Good luck to you, sir, on that. Thanks again for watching the channel. Sorry about that. Kind of an unusual situation. Tech Tuesday continues.
Yes, this one comes from Stefan. I know you're a busy man. I have a 2020 C8, and I've had an issue with the radio not shutting off after the car is off and the doors even open. It goes off after the allotted timeout time. Also, the update is gray and says the car must be in park to do the update, even though the car is in park. I called the dealer, and I said there's no updates. Have you heard of anything like this before?
I was just going to say, it sounds like he needs an update.
Yeah.
Because I had that issue before when I didn't do the update, when it was a radio-specific update, and the radio stayed on, so...
Yeah. I know they're continually updating this radio. Even though I've updated radios, they come back with another update on them.
Right. So... In your infotainment screen, go to your settings button, go to the system tab, and search for updates. If it says install now, wait for the prompts to tell you to actually get out of the car. Then you can get out of the car so you don't break the cycle of electrics. And that way the update's actually going to happen. So it does sound like you need an update. Or they come and see you where you do the hard download on a jump drive and do the update that way.
Right.
It takes a little bit longer to do that, but it does sound like he needs an update.
Yeah, it sounds like he needs an update. And like you said, get in, shut the door, key it up, bring up the prompts on the driver information display, and then sit there and read them carefully
and wait.
Do exactly what it tells you to do when it tells you to do it, and make sure you're out in an open area. You can't be in the garage, you can't be up against a building.
Good point.
You got to be out in an open area.
Yep.
And the download will go through.
Okay.
All right. The next question comes from Jimmy. He says, a huge fan of the channel. Wife and I always tune in on Sundays and Tuesdays to watch the video. I wanted to take a moment to say thanks for everything you do and provide the insight to the current mania revolving around the C8 market and productivity.
Yes.
I want to take a moment and ask a question to you and Chuck. Is the electronic parking brake module, is this a serviceable part?
Also, the electronic brake, is it serviceable?
Yes.
Okay, I wonder why he's asking that. Okay, go ahead.
Well, I don't know why he's asking that either. Also, I want to know why this can't be color matched to the brake caliper. For example, see the image attached. You can choose any color for the brake calipers, but the EPB module is always a different color. Can this be vinyl wrapped or better yet, powder coated?
So it sounds like he's asking two questions, because one's the brake module and the other one's the actual emergency brake that he's talking about on the back of the wheel. You see that one, he's got a picture on the back there real quick. Yeah. I'm just going to throw that up before you go ahead and answer. Sorry about that. So he's talking back in here, guys.
Right.
And it's not color-coded. And I think, more importantly, that's for aesthetics. I think that would throw, if you had just the back wheel, two colored, you know, yellow, and then the front one just has a one yellow, then it looks like you're missing something on the front wheel. That's one, I think, more importantly, aesthetics. So, again, it's a two-part question. I don't know how you want to proceed from there.
Well, I think you hit that one right on the nail. Right on the head there, because like you said, if you had two yellows on the rear and not only one on the front, it'd be like,
hey, what's up?
What's
fall off your car?
Yeah.
Yeah, right, absolutely.
As far as the brake module, it is a serviceable part. It's part of the brake booster that sits out in front of the car.
Mm-hmm.
There's detailed, in-depth stuff you have to do to get that off.
Yeah, those wires are in there tight. I mean, you got to disassemble a lot to get to it.
Yeah, you do.
Okay, so yeah, thank you for watching. Thanks for the compliment. We don't know why you would need to get to that. I say don't get to that. Use guys like him to get to that in the event that you need to.
Exactly.
And one more for you guys before we wipe off. We'll actually got to wipe on some more and then wipe off the dielectric grease on the car. What else you got there? That's a quick one. That came by a text.
Yeah, I don't know.
818 area code.
How do I change the hydraulic fluid in my 2014 Chevy Corvette convertible top? Okay, I don't know why you want to change the fluid, but if you take the carpet out of the rear, and if you see here, there's a black panel that covers, this is the motor, and the module assembly with all the hydraulic lines going to it, you got to be extremely, extremely careful.
Oh, man.
This is the fill plug right here.
Okay.
So if you do get to this, you would have to figure out a way to suck all this fluid out without, you put the convertible top up
because
you, and get in the trunk, take the trunk carpet out, take this rear cover off, take this plug out, be very careful. It's a black brass plug that screws into plastic. You don't want to crack it, taking it out or putting it in. Suck the fluid out and put new fluid in, and that is a very explicit fluid to this system. You absolutely have to get the correct fluid or you will contaminate the system and destroy it.
Oh, wow.
So
okay,
be very careful of the fluid that you put in this.
Okay.
It should have, shouldn't have to be changed. It's kind of like a lifetime fluid, but if you want to change it, that's how you do it.
There you go. All right. Thank you, 818, for the text. Thank you, everybody, for joining us on Tech Tuesday. We've got to apply a little bit more dielectric grease and then wipe off what is on there right now. I'm going to go ahead and wipe off what's on there right now. Get this right here while he does that. Yeah, so again, in case you missed that early on when we were doing all this, this one molding, not this molding here, but right up against the back window that we were talking about with John, that his window exploded, which is really bizarre. This molding, the tonneau cover, sits right on top of that. So, and there's dust there. You can feel that dust. So I'm sure that's going to cause some of the situations that Chuck and I have been talking about and that I've already experienced in my car. Almost a year old, and I've got 12,000 miles on it right now. Yeah, baby, got another day crazy trip just like Ryan and I did last year to Mackinac and back. Stay tuned for that. We're going, Chucky, we're going to St. Louis.
Are you?
Yeah, I want to see, you guys can answer in the comments if you want, but I want to see if the Corvette assembly plant is still there and what the state of affairs is for that area. If they've done it, I just don't know off the top of my head if they've done anything with that plant. So I'm going to drive around that area, and then Ryan and I are going to enjoy the drive, and we're going to go up in the Arch in St. Louis. If you've never done that, it is quite a thrill. I did it back in 2005 when we did some Corvette testing for Chevrolet for the C6 Corvette at Gateway Speedway there. That was pretty neat, so I really enjoyed that. How am I doing? Did I get everything here, or I missed one on the side?
I just wanted to say, this is, like I was telling you, it's like drywall, less is more.
Yes.
So there's not a big glob you're wiping off, you're just kind of wiping off the excess.
Yes.
So.
Good. And we're going to let that sit back there for a little bit, and then we'll be good.
Yeah.
Pretty good with that. So good. Hope you guys enjoyed this one today. Thanks for responding. We do read the comments. And this was a good point, because we have talked about it in the past, and so I'm assuming that maybe you caught that video, but as the channel grows, maybe some folks didn't see that video that we were talking about what we're doing right now. So we do enjoy actually doing the hands-on stuff for you guys. My ceramic coating's not put on yet, but she still looks good. This car looks good dirty. I do love my baby.
Take your pucks and roll out.
Get the puck out of here.
Yeah,
right.
Get the puck out of here.
All right, fantastic.
Too young, and I didn't understand that you were no one. Amends. If I am known then, or what I know now. have said what I said. I took the long road, thought I'd be better on my own. Sometimes what's right is wrong instead. Cause I was too young, and I didn't understand that you young, and I didn't understand that you.